Welcome to another food adventure with Getting Lost. Today, we're in the middle of the CBD area at Tanjung Pagar Plaza Food Center, where the food center is on the second floor, and we're going there to eat food like this, a rice like this, a noodle dish like this, and another noodle dish. So, join me at this food center, where the bottom part is actually the wet market and the top part is where the food center is. So let's get going and let's get eating. How to get there? We are actually at Tanjung Pagar MRT station. You can see all the gantry gates. Over here is the entrance to Tanjung Pagar Center. So once you get out of the gantry, you turn left. You're actually on the east-west line now. Okay. So once you go left, you will be seeing an escalator. There's one escalator on this side and one escalator on the right side. You can take both escalators. Okay, this is the older escalator which we're gonna take up now. So basically, we're gonna take this escalator up. Just keep heading up. Oh, over here, this platform here, if you turn left, there's actually a lot of food outlets over here too. You can also have some food here, but we are gonna head to Tanjung Pagar Plaza this time. Okay, so we head up here, and as you can see, this entrance is actually newly renovated. So they actually renovated the whole entrance because of the Tanjung Pagar Center. Okay, so once you get out of the gantry, you turn left, you walk straight down here. Okay, as you can see in front of you is actually the Icon Apartments. Okay, so over here you turn right, and in front of you there's actually a pedestrian crossing. You're gonna take this pedestrian crossing. Okay, to your left here is actually a hotel called Oasia. Okay, so it has a very natural look because they actually have vegetation going along the side of the building. Okay, so just keep heading straight. Okay, in front of you is actually Tas Street. Be careful, this is actually a two-way street. So when you're crossing the road, you make sure you have to look both ways. Okay. So Trust Street, okay. So after you pass Trust Street, you keep walking straight, and you keep walking straight until this road here, which in front of you is now Tanjung Pagar Road. Okay, so you're gonna have to cross the road here, and directly opposite here is Tanjung Pagar Food Center. Okay, so let's just be careful when you cross the road. All right. Look at the cars. Okay, so this is the food center, two levels. The bottom level is a wet market, the top level is where the food center is, and that's where we are going. So we are at Tanjung Pagar Plaza Food Center. Let's head up stairs to eat the food. The first food we're eating here today is actually from this store here called Rong Xing Yong Tau Fu. This is a very popular Yong Tau Fu. You come here breakfast time, lunch time. That's the best time to come because if you come late lunch, late afternoon, everything is finished, anything is sold out. So they open in the morning and they're sold out by lunch time. So there's such a long queue for this Yong Tau Fu. So basically you can have ordered what I did with only the Yong Tau Fu itself, or you can order it together with noodles. Okay, you have the white variety noodles, you can have egg noodles, you can have bee hoon, you can have kuay teow. So you can choose different types of noodles, or you can have it like me, just the Yong Tau Fu together with the soup. You can also have this Yong Tau Foo in soup or dry, which is the version I chose now, dry. All the Yong Tau Foo items are homemade, okay, and they actually do the items quite well, just that the items have shrunk from last time when I ate it. Last time I ate it, their items were actually much bigger. Now, because of the price of things going up, inflation, everything, so the food items also are getting smaller. Anyway, but that was many years ago. Anyway, the items are well made. It goes very well with the sauce. If you eat it with the chili sauce does have a bit of a kick to it. Quite nice. They actually do the Yong Tau Foo here quite well. If you like Yong Tau Foo, this is a very good place to have it. Even though it's deep fried, it's not too oily or greasy. And the soup is good. The soup, as you can see, has a very strong soybean taste because it's cooked together with soybean. So at the bottom there, you actually can see the soybean inside. I actually had some seaweed added to the soup. But overall, a very good Yong Tau Foo with a very good soup stock. Next up, for those people who come here often, is called Makan Sutra Nasi Lemak Pandan Rice. Okay, this is one of three nasi lemak stalls at this food center. All three nasi lemak stalls do very well. All three nasi lemak stalls open during lunchtime, open for breakfast, and sell out during lunchtime. You come during lunchtime, they could be sold out. The thing will be closed, and if you can see at the next table there, they get a lot of takeaway orders. So that's one of the reasons why their items are well sought after. Okay, so here is the rice itself. As you can see, the rice is a bit greenish in color, and it does have a bit of the pandan leaf taste, pandan leaf smell. Okay, so it's served together. Also, I ordered a few items. So I ordered a ngoh hiang, I ordered a meatball, I ordered chicken wing, there's a chili, then I ordered a fried egg together with ikan bilis and peanuts. So this is the nasi lemak itself. The nasi lemak itself, the rice is nice and firm, not too oily, and it has a slight pandan smell. The difference here is the ngoh hiang and the meatball, which you don't normally get when you eat nasi lemak. The chili is a bit sweet and savory. The egg is just normal, and the chicken is just like normal fried chicken. Overall, this is a okay nasi lemak. Not the best I feel here, but not too bad. Next up is this place called Lucky Wonton Noodles. They actually sell wonton noodles together with roast barbecue pork with dumplings. They even sell hor fun together with shredded chicken. Okay, I ordered the wonton noodles with barbecue pork. So here is it. Here's the noodles itself. The barbecue pork is actually okay. For Singapore style barbecue pork, their barbecue pork is not too bad. The noodles itself is nice and firm, but somehow the sauce they put into the noodles itself, the soya sauce, doesn't really get onto the noodles itself and doesn't really add much flavor to the noodles. And the char siu is Singapore style and it's lean meat, but it's not too bad. One thing good is the vegetable is actually done very nicely. They blanch it very nicely. The dumplings are small, but not too bad. Tastes okay, just that only it's a small side. The soup is tasteless. But one thing I need to say is I actually had these noodles together with chili sauce. So the sambal chili they put in here actually overpower all the taste of the soya sauce. So you do not actually get to taste. You just get to taste the sambal chili itself. Like here I said, the noodles itself, the soup, it's a bit tasteless after you eat the sambal chili. Okay, you don't taste much taste at all, just but the dumplings is not too bad. Dumplings are actually quite nice. Next up is this place called Sung Heng Food Deluxe. It serves one of my favorite dish, which is called lor mee. Okay, so this is the lor mee itself. So basically, it has a very starchy sauce. Okay, and you need to pour some vinegar on it. And the starchy sauce is actually very flavorful. It's very flavorful, and you have sambal together with minced garlic, and you also have cut chilies, and you have coriander. The cut chilies here are actually the chili padi or the bird's eye chili, which is very spicy. So if you do not want it to be spicy, you need to take it out. And then you have this thing, which is like a deep fried wonton. And then you have nuggets of meat or fish. And then you also have stewed pork inside. Okay. Overall, and then you also have half an egg together with flat egg noodles. Overall, this is a very, very good lor mee. It's delicious. The braising, the starchy sauce is actually very flavorful, and you need to add in a vinegar element to it, which actually ties in all the flavors together. Very nice. So you need to mix up everything together. So you have the garlic, you have the vinegar, you have the very good starchy sauce. All goes well together with the noodles. Okay then, so this is our first visit to Tanjong Pagar Plaza Food Center. I hope you enjoyed it. There's a lot of good food here. If you do come here, in the next video, I'll recommend you the final two nasi lemak stores. Anyway, so what you need to do now is I need you to actually help me to like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to join me for my next food adventure. Bye bye.